Hello, welcome to the session on conversion of context-free grammar to Chomsky normal form. At the end of this session, students will be able to convert a context-free grammar to Chomsky normal form. We convert the given grammar into Chomsky normal form. That is producing AX format. Now in this case, initially we start with the grammar G consisting of format G is equal to VTPS, that is non-terminal, terminals, production and start. Next, we are eliminating useless variables that cannot be become terminals, then eliminate useless variables that cannot be reached, then elimination of null production, elimination of unit production, then conversion of grammar to Chomsky normal form. Now in this given grammar, S producing AACD, A producing AAB or null, C producing AC or A, D producing ADA or BDB or null. In this first step, we will check whether any useless production is present. Here S is starting AACD, A is having value, C is having terminal value, D is having terminal value. So here there is no useless production which is not having terminal value. Now next we'll check useless variable that cannot be reached. Now here S is having values, C is having values and D is also having values. So S is reaching to every variable. So there is no useless variable that cannot be reached. So we will move to the next step. Here we will check null production and eliminate if any present. Here in this production, A and D are having null productions. So here we can see that L is producing null, D is producing null. Now these are nullable variables. A and D are nullable variables. Now in this A variable, after null replacement, we'll check what are the changes will be there. In this case, this is the new grammar we are defining. Now here, AACD, only single variable it was defining first. Now when we are putting null, at that time A will be null. So your value will be ACD. Next, A will be null. So your value will be again ACD is there. Then next we will check for D. We are putting the value of D is null. So we are getting AAC. Next when we are putting both A and A null value, we are getting CD. And when A and D both value we are putting null, only C remains. So that value is C. So next A is there. Here there is no value for that. So only A is there which is having null value. So we are putting here A is null. So it will get AB value. In this case AC is there as it is. There is no use of capital A and capital D. And in the D value we are putting here A and D. So only D is there. So when we are putting D as a null, so we are getting AA and here BB. So here we have produced new grammar by with using that elimination of null variables. Next, we are having the elimination of unit production. Here we need to search unit production in the given grammar. As we have seen, we can check the unit production here. No, here no. Here C is the unit production in the start symbol S. So the and that is the single unit production. Nowhere other places we are finding any unit production. Now by putting the value of C wherever the C is present, we will get that new grammar. Now here C value is AC and A. So we are putting here in the S instead of C, keeping the value AC and A. So here we are eliminating any unit production, that is C. Next, now once the format is clear, now we can convert CNF format, that is A defining or A producing AX. Now here restricting right side of the production to single terminal or string of two or more variables. Now steps, in this we'll add XA and XB instead of single terminal wherever it is present. Now wherever single terminal A is there, we are not replacing, but wherever this A, B, these terminals are there, we are putting XA value for A and XB value for B. Now accordingly we'll see that new grammar is there. So AACD, here we found first single A with non-terminal, so it is replaced by XC. Next, in the A, XA is replaced, here B is replaced as XB. So here again XA and XB. Here again XA, this is a single terminal. So next, whatever A is replaced by XA, then XA like this, all B's XB, XB, XA, XA and XB, XB. So this is the new grammar we are producing. Now one more step here, it is whatever big or long productions are there, we have to short that productions. Now I'll take one example how to short that productions. Here AACD has to be converted into the short. So directly I'm keeping S producing AT1. T1 is what? T1 is equal to AT2 and T2 is CD. Like that ACD is converted into S producing AU1, AAC is producing S AV1, and like this what the next all the productions are shown over here and they all are shortened, and thus we have converted the CFG into CNF. Here is one question for you. Remove the null production from the following grammar. Here S is having this value and A is having this value. If you find any null production here, then remove it. After elimination of the null production, we are getting the new value. So here A is having null value. So we are putting wherever the A values are there and we are keeping the null values. So here first, here we are putting null value. So ABC, here BAC, then both A's as a null value. So BC value is there. So these are the new values. If any duplicate, then you can remove it and you can write that new value. Thank you.